FM News. On point.
Take a look at the news. Democratic Party will start presidential campaigns in Kasese District, Rwenzori region, and later continue to the other parts of the country. In the campaign program submitted to the Electoral Commission today, the oldest party's presidential flag bearer, Norbert Mao, will start the campaigns Wednesday 11th and not today as the party, as other flag bearers. Party spokesperson Opiyo Okol says they have decided to start the campaigns in Kasese as a sign of respect to the cultural institution in accordance with the security attack on the kingdom of Rwenzururu, where people were killed and the king arrested.
The people of Kasese are like orphans. If you recollect in 2016 or towards the end of 2016, the government through the police and the army unleashed terror on the people of Kasese. They unleashed terror on the kingdom of Rwenzururu. And as I speak now, the Omusinga is actually was driven out of his kingdom. So as DP, we chose to begin from Kasese as a sign of commiserating with them, and one, commiserating with them, and secondly, to give them hope, a new hope, that our government as DP shall actually be a government that respects traditional leaders and traditional institutions.
High Court has declined to hold hearing of the murder case against businessman Matthew Kanyamunyu as he continues to pursue the actually traditional justice system. Kanyamunyu's trial judge Stephen Mubiru to hold hearing of his case, saying he initiated the traditional justice system, commonly known as Matoput, which has not been finalized. Judge Mubiru explained what happens with Matoput, where the accused admits the offense publicly and is made to drink bitter herbs, and a sheep is slaughtered, among others, as a purification process. He says in the instant application, he does not explain whether he admitted to the offense publicly, but explained what transpired with the deceased relatives. Judge Mubiru said Matoput is good if people know each other and within the same locality, like the case was between the Acholi and Itesot, because it helps stop bloodshed and revenge. But in this case, the murder happened miles away from Acholi land, and the accused Kanyamunyu is not known to the Acholi people. He said if he wanted a genuine reconciliation, he would have pleaded guilty to the murder, hence dismissing his application and ordering that the case must continue. Three civil servants at Buvuma District Headquarters have tested positive for COVID-19, and this brings the number of cases 64 in the district. According to the district information officer, Zabio Waswa, district offices have been closed temporarily to give way for fumigation till Wednesday. Now, Waswa advises civil servants to test, as this will help them know the status and keep their loved ones safe.
We registered three positive cases of COVID-19 from among our local government staff. Two of these are working at the district headquarters, and one is a health worker. This brings the total number of COVID-19 positive cases in the whole district at 64 from the samples we took. Effective today, our district headquarters have been locked from access. We are fumigating until Wednesday next week. Our staff have been called upon to go and test for COVID-19.
South Sudanese national football team will be training at St. Mary's Chitende for 2 days as CAF requirement ahead of the 2021 Africa Cup of Nations qualification game against Uganda Cranes. The contingent of 32 players and officials arrived in the country yesterday ahead of the game to be played Thursday 12th at St. Mary's Stadium, and is currently residing at Imperial Botanica Hotel in Tebe. FUFA spokesperson Ahmed Hussein says it is mandatory for a visiting team to get a feel of the pitch where the game is going to be hosted.
The national team of South Sudan arrived in Uganda with a 32-man contingent ahead of their AFCON 2021 qualifier with Uganda Cranes on Thursday at St. Mary's Stadium, Chitende. They have been booked in at Imperial Hotel in Tebe, and they will have also their first training sessions, depending on how the coach comes up with that. But the mandatory training sessions will be on Tuesday and Wednesday, as per the CAF guidelines.
In other news, the Nelson Mandela Foundation has celebrated the projected defeat of Donald Trump, his presidency, and urged President-elect Joe Biden to fix the problems of racism, sexism, xenophobia, and Afrophobia. It is with a sense of relief that we have seen President Donald Trump defeated in the U.S. presidential election, like many around the world, to celebrate the fact that we won't have to watch him undermining democratic institutions, the foundation said in a statement. Mr. Trump is yet to concede, and Mr. Biden's win remains a projection. The foundation urged Mr. Trump to support what it termed a difficult transition. I quote, as Nelson Mandela often used to say, a good leader knows when to step down and how to do so appropriately. It's not too late for Trump to embrace dignity for himself and for others. African leaders have been congratulating President-elect Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala Harris.